New York's Attorney General seeks court sanctions against Donald Trump in relation to a civil fraud lawsuit against the former U.S. president. The case, filed in September last year, accused Trump, his children, and the Trump Organization of manipulating asset values for investment and loan purposes. Attorney General Letitia James wants the sanctions imposed after the defendants provided frivolous responses to her inquiries. A new video of Trump's deposition in August showed him continuously invoking the Fifth Amendment and declining to answer questions about his company. The Trump Organization is at risk of facing civil penalties as James's office seeks $250 million and a permanent ban on Trump from doing business in New York. The lawsuit is scheduled for a trial in October. Western countries impose new sanctions on Myanmar to mark the second anniversary of the military's uprising. The sanctions by the U.S. targets for the first time Myanmar's energy officials and its mining enterprises. Similar measures against a military-run country were also announced by Canada, Australia, and the U.K. Myanmar's armed forces seized power in 2021 after complaints of electoral fraud. That coup led to the ouster of Aung San Suu Kyi, who has been detained since and is serving up to 30 years in jail. It has also plunged the country into turmoil, with local rights groups estimating nearly 3,000 have been killed in the military's crackdown on dissent. 100 people are now confirmed dead from the suicide bombing in Pakistan. The January 30th explosion in the city of Peshawar is now deemed the deadliest attack in the country in years. Some 217 others were injured. An investigation into the bombing is now underway. Police say more than 25 pounds of explosives were used by the suicide bomber to stage the attack. No group has so far claimed responsibility. Alec Baldwin formally charged with involuntary manslaughter over the accidental shooting of a cinematographer on the set of the movie Rust. The actor was holding a handgun during rehearsals when it discharged a live bullet, killing Helena Hutchins in October 2021. Prosecutors in Santa Fe, New Mexico, filed the charges Tuesday as they alleged the veteran actor had not been properly trained to handle the weapon. Baldwin's lawyers vowed to fight the charge, which the actor previously called a terrible miscarriage of justice. If convicted, Baldwin will face up to 18 months in jail and a $5,000 fine. Manila and Tokyo may sign 7 bilateral deals during Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s visit to Japan next week. These would include agreements in infrastructure development, defense, and agriculture, among others.
The Department of Foreign Affairs considers the President's visit to Japan as consequential. Japan is the first country with which the Philippines has forged a strategic partnership. The official working visit is expected to reaffirm the strong and vibrant relations between the two countries. It also seeks to maximize the full potential of the Philippines-Japan strategic partnership in all its aspects and facilitate closer defense, security, political, economic, and people-to-people ties.
Marcos will be in Japan from February 8th to 12th to meet with Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida. This will be his 9th overseas trip since he took office in June last year. U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin back in the Philippines for another official visit. The Pentagon chief was welcomed by U.S. Ambassador to the Philippines Mark A. Carlson and other officials during his arrival in Manila Tuesday night. On Wednesday, he visited the Philippine military's Western Mindanao Command in Zamboanga City. He was welcomed by Armed Forces Chief General Andres Centino and the chief of the West MINCOM, Lieutenant General Roy Galido. The Pentagon earlier said Austin's trip is meant to reaffirm Washington's pledge to its allies and partners to preserve a free and open Indo-Pacific. His visit comes amid tensions between Beijing and Manila due to maritime and territorial disputes in the South China Sea. Austin last visited the Philippines in July 2021 to discuss security issues.